goes on and on. Now he'll throw with Brady. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And the offense moving quickly to the line. To throw is Brady. Complete to the right side. It's Eifert. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 18 yards on the pickup there. And it'll be a Los Angeles first down. Throwing on first down is Brady. On the screen, Bernard. And he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves his sticks. Into the red zone, it's Brady. That is caught inside the five. And he's brought down. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Brady to throw again. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him.
Pressure down it goes. Sacked at the 10. Jason Pierre-Paul in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Brady now on third and goal. And he can't quite pick it. No interception so far. That probably should have been their first, but at least it's fourth down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Brady gonna go on fourth down. And this is caught. He's got a touchdown, LA. Their dangerous wide receiver from 8 yards out. And his guys are able to make this a close game again.
Fourth and goal, and they found a way to throw it in the end zone for a touchdown.
And these defenses, they just like three downs, get off the field. But here they had to go four, couldn't get it.
And at the time, you're looking up and saying, okay, if I hold them for three, at worst, I give up a field goal attempt. When they go for it, sometimes it really affects the defense because maybe they're not mentally prepared to go that fourth down.
So just a three-point game now as they send this one away. The return man here, Dwayne Harris. They juked him. They begin the drive with Rashad Jennings. And he works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Snap comes at one. Manning. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense at that time, harmlessly to the ground. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
I feel like Eli Manning has just gone from downfield bomber to a guy who can complete everything.
He can hit him underneath now.
Yeah, we just saw that there with that pass completion. The maturity of the veteran taking with the defense again.
Now it's Jennings. Well, no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
They were stopped on that play. We've had plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then, the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
They go play action for Jennings. For a heavy rush, and down he goes. Deion Jones. Him for a loss of 7.
Partner, I know the ball security is preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was 3rd and 10 versus 3rd and 12 as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
Welcome back live to Orlando. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. They'll run it now. Out of the gun. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Offense walks to the line for play number seven of the drive. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just more football. The Trinity defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line. And there's a nice stop for the defense. They've had a tough time containing this guy all game long. But maybe they can build a little bit off of that play, a little bit of confidence, a little bit of momentum. Yeah, every now and then you can actually tackle that guy.
Here's Brad Wing now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory.
Looking for his tight end read, and it's intercepted. A great read, and they bring it back. It's a pick six on Giants touchdown. Short throw pick six right there, those linebackers. They love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. On the return, the old reliable Devin Hester, the veteran. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. Waiting now on first down. And pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
There goes Sterling Shepard. Touchdown! Shepard, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And his guys have made this a one-score game now. Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air, because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that into the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
Here's Harris to return it. The Giants offense back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
So they're leading. They have possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock. They run again to Jennings. And for one of the few times here today, this one's not going to go anywhere. Devin McCourty brings him down. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead. Here's Marine. Not much much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. Here's Brad Wing now as he'll punt it away for the second time. On his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. Here's Jones. That'll wind up being a 50-yard punt, though they do get 10 back on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. We get a look now at the Giants' defense as they file into position. And everything's going to rest on this drive. Can they keep them out of field goal range? Because a field goal would win it.
So now you're in that position of you can't just back off and give them easy throws. At the same time, you don't want to press them so hard they go over the top and beat you deep. So you're playing a tight defense with an idea that you have the lead, whatever you do, then let them in the field goal range and give that up.
Maybe tight, but not too tight.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, it's perfect, right? It's kind of like lacing up your shoes. Get it exactly right and no more.
See if they lace them right. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Back to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. He's back to throw. It's held in by Shepard. And down inside the 15 he goes. Giants, they get the officials' attention and take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Back to throw. Caught over the middle. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Tyler Eifert in the final minute. And his guys have taken the lead here in the fourth.
So many practices we watched over time where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there.
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? Dancing to his left. And this one incomplete. So they went for the two. They don't get it. The third time wasn't a charm. They got the first two-point tries. Still have the lead, but couldn't get the third.
Okay, so they didn't get this one. But I have to ask you, what matchup are they seeing that they feel that confident to go for two so often?
Yeah, and we talk about this a lot, but it has to be something, you're right, that they saw all week, correct?
Definitely game plan for it. Felt good about being aggressive and going for it. And right up until that one, they've gotten two for two.
The New York set to take the field. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat-and-mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. They'll look to throw. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to let it fly. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. One receiver left, three to the right. Now Manning, gotta have this one. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty, and with that, the ball game is over. Well, I know at points in this one you wanted to close.
Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos, follow me on social media, and once again, thanks for watching.